On Easter Monday 1916, we set out to challenge the then mighty British Empire, to ensure that the children of the nation would be born in freedom, that they would never know the humiliation and shame of living under alien rule, or endure the truculence of a foreign soldiery. My part was a very small one, but still I was there. I was born in Scotland of Irish parents, and was a member of Cumnam On there. When Countess Markievicz, as promised, sent me word of the date of the proposed rising, I came to Ireland on Holy Thursday. I stayed with Countess Markievicz and joined the Irish Citizen Army, of which she was an officer. On Easter Monday morning, I was sent by James Connolly, Commander-in-Chief of the Dublin area, to scout around the barracks to see if troops were stirring. They were not, and in fact, I learned later that many of their officers were off to the races at Ferry House. On returning to report, I was detailed as dispatch rider for the Stevens Green area under Commandant Michael Mallon. When I reached the green ahead of our contingent, I saw one policeman, the last I saw till the rising was over. They simply disappeared from the streets. I was next sent by Commandant Mallon to learn if troops were leaving Beggar's Bush or Portobello Barracks, but everything was quiet. Next, I went to see if the volunteers had occupied Harcourt Street Station. By the time I returned, our men were entrenching themselves in Stevens Green. Commandant Mallon then gave me my first dispatch to headquarters at the GPO, where I saw the fruitless attempt on the GPO by the 5th Lancers. Twice on Monday, soldiers from Portobello Barracks attempted an attack on our position at St. Stephen's Green. First, they got as far as Portobello Bridge, where they were fired on by our men from the roof of Davies Public House. The second time, they were turned back in Harcourt Street, when Countess Markievicz and Councillor Partridge fired on them, killing two of their officers. On Monday night, we camped out in Stephen's Green, but during the night, British troops had gained possession of the Shelburne Hotel, and at 4 o'clock in the morning, they started machine gun fire on us. This made it impossible for us to stay in the green, so it was decided to take possession of the College of Surgeons. We lost one of our boys, James Fox, who was killed before we left the green. I was then sent to bring in 16 men who were guarding Leeson Street Bridge, who would otherwise have been cut off from us. They all arrived safely at the College of Surgeons. I had ridden ahead to report to Commandant Mallon, and as he stood listening to me, a bullet whizzed through his hat. He took off his hat, looked at it without comment, and put it on again. This hat may be seen in the 1916 section in the National Museum. On Wednesday, we spent most of our time sniping at the British from the roof of the College of Surgeons, and on Wednesday night, Commandant Mallon sent two squads to cut off some British who had planted a machine gun on the roof of University Church. I was in charge of one squad of four men. When we reached the building at the foot of Harcourt Street, which was to be set on fire, Councillor Partridge burst the lock of the door with his rifle butt. The rifle went off, and the flash revealed our position to the enemy, who were in the Sinn Féin bank opposite. I turned to call the men to come on, heard a volley, and fell wounded. I was carried out to the street, and there lay Fred Ryan, a lad of 17. He was dead. I was carried back to the College of Surgeons and had my wounds attended to. And although so badly wounded, I had to laugh when the men and women around me took a cough which I was trying to suppress as the death rattle. I remained in the College of Surgeons till the surrender, when I was sent to St. Vincent's Hospital. All reports that came to me there were of death and prison sentences. Day after day, the executions went on. Even James Connolly, badly wounded, was placed in a chair and shot. Countess Markievicz received a life sentence. As you know, children, we did not win a military victory in 1916, but we roused the people, and all over the country, men joined in the fight for independence and rid at least part of our country of the foreign army that had held us in bondage for hundreds of years.